What's up, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Dalton. Welcome back to the channel. I ride and race bikes. If you are new here, welcome to the channel. I appreciate you watching. And today I have something super special on the agenda for you. This is the T-shirt ride episode 4. For those of you that are new to the channel, the T-shirt ride is a series that I'm really excited about. I started this about a year ago when I first started my channel, and I want to pick it back up now that race season is sort of coming to an end. So this individual is somebody super cool that I met really early on in my cycling career down here in San Diego. It's been really cool knowing this person. We became really good friends. So I'm really stoked on you guys getting to meet this individual. But anyway, without further ado, let's jump right into it.
How's it going? I'm Max Haggard, part owner and manager of Guillotine Cycling, and I'm the owner of Line of Best Fitting. I'm a bike racer in Southern California, and this is me, and this is Wind and Sea Beach.
All right, bye. I like that we pick 5 p.m. to do this when all the cars are out.
Yeah,
mad traffic
hours.
Yeah. You're on the TT whip too, look at that.
We're not really early starters though.
You're gonna be going way faster than I am. Just because of your natural aero position.
Yeah.
I'm on this whip. Alright, so we're gonna kick this thing off before we even get out the hood. I'm gonna ask you, where are we going today, dude? Where are you taking me and what are you showing me?
We're gonna cruise up Calf Street.
Cool.
We're gonna take the bike path by my old high school. We're gonna go get Don Carlos for
dinner. Stop in and hoop up on some kids.
That's right, that's right.
All right, Don Carlos.
Don Carlos. We're gonna stop by the beach. I'm gonna give you like a little scenic tour of where I grew up.
Fun fact, I live in the same hood now. Which means we're neighbors.
I grew up in PB. Don't tell people I grew up in La Jolla.
Why?
There's a divide there, you know?
Oh, okay.
If you're from Southern California, if you're from San Diego, like, oh, he's from La Jolla. Oh, he's from La Jolla. Nah, I'm from PB. I'm not from Mission Beach, though. I am from Pacific Beach.
So there's a divide there, too, then.
Yeah, this is all really culturally relevant if you're from San Diego. Like, I want a little bit of separation.
If you fall and break your hip, video over.
Video's over.
So one good thing I will say is we've already shot this and I'm an idiot and had a corrupt SD card because I let it run all the way to the hour and a half mark and the GoPro died.
Yeah, not a good look.
Yeah, just, you know, me being good at stuff. So then it deleted all that footage. But the positive here is that it's been so long since we shot it that I have zero idea what we actually talked about. So this is all a new experience for me.
It's like a goldfish.
Exactly. Well, I'm like that anyway. I think last time you told me a story about Calf Street Bar and Grill, but then since then,
we've become frequent denizens.
Exactly. I heard some two dudes that looked exactly like us two dudes held down the pool table there for like 3.5 hours one night.
I think that was us actually.
Yeah, you heard? Oh, really?
I heard it was us.
Oh, okay. Yeah, see, I didn't know.
Just a rumor though.
I was probably blacked out.
That was the first ever bar I went into. 21st birthday. I don't drink. But I went in there and I was like, no one carded me at the door. I walked up to the bar, ordered a beer. No one carded me at the bar. I was like, look, lady. Someone's got to card me in this establishment.
Yo, let us get that draft, dude.
Race you. Yeah, I could probably smoke him.
That's totally on the mic.
I can probably smoke him.
You can't see things under your breath because everything will be heard.
I'm gonna smoke him. TTASMR. I can go as fast as maybe a 25cc scooter.
Woo!
As long as it's a fat dude sitting on it.
You know, this hill is like steeper than it feels.
Yeah, it's like the longest false flat.
It feels steeper than it is, something like that. Look at us being good citizens and obeying laws. Stopping at stop signs.
In California, you can now legally yield at a stop sign. Because that would have gotten us hit back there, but legally.
Just roll it.
Just roll it. Yeah. You're legally allowed to. You still have right of way underneath the bumper of a car.
What is that? A 38?
Like probably a 40.
That is one benefit about living here, is all the nicey nice views. All right, so growing up, what got you into bikes originally?
I mean, wearing the shirt. I was a BMX kid growing up.
Ooh.
So.
How many sick tricks can you do?
Dude, all of them.
All the sick tricks?
All of them. I was on X Games mode.
Wait, before you continue this train of thought, who's better on the BMX, you or Tolly?
Oh, Tolly for sure. No BMX beat. All right. That fool smoked me. I was a BMX kid.
Doing sick tricks.
Doing sick tricks.
Whoa.
And then I was
hop?
I can.
The DT bike.
I was a BMX kid, and then I was a fixie kid.
Riders up.
Oh, car.
Car up. Where are we going?
I watched Corn Fed and Line of Sight, which are some OG fixie docs. And then I got my first like real track bike, which is a Leader 725.
Is it a steel frame or what's
aluminum?
Aluminum.
Went straight to Hydroformed 7000 series aluminum.
That's some high tech stuff, dude.
Yeah, it's some big boy stuff.
So you were just big balling, slinging bike parts on the street to
on the
get
street,
your,
on the mean
your track fix.
And then I finally got a road bike, and that was sick. I started off on a giant Defy. I ended up with a Cervelo RS, which is a hell of a bike. And then from there, I went Cervelo S5, giant Propel, Cervelo S5 again. So the only two bike brands I've ever actually ridden have been Giant and Cervelo. So shouts out to Giant and Cervelo. I've been a long time fan, and now they're finally a short-term fan of me.
At least for a year.
At least until January 1st. Fingers crossed they're a fan of me next year too.
Bro.
Peter Stetna who?
Yeah, Peter Stetna, come at us. Ugh, I think this actually makes us the Gravel Privateers.
I think this, this officially, if I hit this.
Oh! Sick trick, see?
Yeah, see,
BMX
that's the BMX background right there.
I mean, your handling skills in the sand on the TT whip seem pretty high. Oh, shit. I almost died. This is how I double flat on a t-shirt ride, going like 6 blocks to a burrito joint.
Hey, it's like 12 blocks to a burrito joint.
You know, I also don't understand why everybody insists on taking me off-road through some cut-through. What's your story? Why this path?
This is the path that I used to ride to high school every day.
Headline, YouTuber dies. Trying to traverse gravel terrain on 25C Vittorias. Where are we at?
And so I started like racing road bikes.
Yeah.
Because I was living in Tacoma at the time. And there
this
was
is this college era or what?
This is college era. This is like right. Freshman, sophomore year of college. And there was this guy who everyone is called Paul Coffey. I'm not even sure if that's his name. But he was this like kind of old timer who rode bikes for this team called Tacoma Bike Shop.
All right. So this was just a bike shop team then?
And I was like doing group rides with them.
Very cool.
And he was like, hey man, you're like good enough that you should be racing bikes. And I was like, all right, yeah, whatever. And then I decided to race my bike for the first time.
Did you win?
I did.
The first time?
The first race I ever did, I won.
Oh my God.
And it's actually coming back up. They're doing a revitalization of it. It's the Harbor Island Last Stand put on by the Werewolves.
And this was your first ever race?
First ever bike race I
and
did.
And you won.
And I won.
So you were the last man standing?
I was the last man standing.
How's
and now,
work?
4 years later, they're bringing it back for the first time.
Sounds like you started racing bikes 4 years ago then, is what you're
like,
saying.
Yeah, like 4 or 5. And then that's when I got picked up by a team called Dos Llantas.
Is that north in Seattle or down here?
No, this is down here.
Okay.
I was living back here at this point.
Okay.
Which was run by a dude named Nick Brock, who I'm really like, grateful for. He like was the first dude who like kind of put me on. And then from there I went to Cal Bike, and then I started Guillotine Cycling, which is where I'm at now.
you know, I feel like there's always a point where somebody's like, you know, I just like riding the bike and this is why.
I rode from San Francisco to Los Angeles with my dad when I was like 15.
That's right? A really long ride.
I had like just gotten my first road bike, that giant Defy.
Uh-huh.
And my dad was like, hey, we should go do this long trip. And it was like 80, 90 miles a day. And it started at the Golden Gate Bridge and it ended at the top of Las Flores Canyon in LA. It was like 5 days, I wanna say. And it was hard. I was like 15 years old, like pretty much completely untrained. I was in like $40 bibs, you know?
So like the good stuff.
The good stuff.
Yeah.
Like ankle socks, just fucking ripping.
Do you ever think that you could actually go that far on a bike in such a short amount of time?
At that time when I was like still just like super young, I was like amazed by that. And there were some times where I would like go out for a century when I was like 15, 16, 17 and not tell anyone and just be gone for like, I don't know, 8 hours.
That's a whip.
My mom would be like calling me. I had like an old flip phone. I didn't answer it because I was just riding, you know, had my iPod shuffle on. And I was like, and she'd like
come home. You got the polyphonic ringtone in the background.
Yeah, dude.
You just don't hear.
I'd just Soulja Boy tell him like, ringtone. But I would like go out for like 8 hour rides and not go very, like go like 80 miles in 8 hours.
You're actually just doing laps around the block until the street lights come on and then your mom's like, yo, time to come home.
Well, I would like get home, my mom would be pissed off. She's like, where have you been?
You're like, hold on, let me pause Soulja Boy.
I was like,
I can't hear you. That's illegal. At least he wears a helmet, kids. Be like Max. Wear a helmet. Ride on the sidewalk. On your TT whip. Run over pedestrians. All recommended activities on a Monday night.
Look, it's the state bird of California.
California state bird.
All right, so where did we just pull up to?
Pulled up to the Mecca of burritos, Don Carlos Taco Shop.
Don Carlos? All right, what's the significance of Don Carlos?
Dude, it's San Diego's finest.
All right.
Also?
This is not like a 3 a.m. spot. This is like actual good burger.
Yeah, this is, yeah, you don't have to be drunk to enjoy Don Carlos Mexican food.
Let's go.
Tons of drunk people do enjoy Don Carlos Mexican food, but it's not a prerequisite, you know?
Okay, that's important.
There are some of those places that like you gotta be sauced. This is not.
Vallarta's. Rigoberto's. Everything else. What do you recommend?
Gotta get the California burrito.
You're currently Cat 2.
Yeah, I'm a Cat 2.
Co-founded Guillotine, right?
Yeah, co-founded Guillotine with a dude named Chris Hildreth.
Okay.
Who's a dude who lives up in LA.
Are we doing a shout-out counter?
Shout-out to Chris Hildreth. I think it's my second shout-out. I don't remember who I shouted out first.
I'll put a counter.
Yeah.
If I can.
Just a little ding.
We got a shout-out Cast Street Bar and Grill.
Yeah, we shout-out Cast Street Bar and Grill.
Cervello and Giant. Dude, there's three. Chris Hildreth.
Ding. Chris Hildreth.
Okay.
Chris Tolley. I think I did a shout-out Chris Tolley.
Okay. Chris Tully.
Yeah, so we're shout out heavy.
We're getting up there. Yeah, you guys have sort of a rock and roll attitude, I guess.
Yeah, it's like very like loud punk rock skinny jeans type, you know.
how many rips are in your skinny jeans?
Dude,
on average?
Just it's more, they're more rips than jeans, you know.
Only because you ripped them doing sick BMX tricks.
Yeah, sick BMX tricks. Mm-hmm. Yeah, no like laser etched hand cut jeans. Only sweat, blood, and tears.
Only laser etched hand cut support plates and bridges for your TT bars, right?
Yeah, laser cut.
Grinder cut.
Angle grinder cut.
Shout out Roger.
Ding. Yeah, shout out to Roger Ainsley. Shout out to Kase.
Ding.
So this is your number three for us.
Is the third kit gonna fire harder than the second kit?
Dude, honestly, I hope so.
Who's your designer?
A woman named, well, I'm gonna design it with a woman named Roz in Seattle.
Okay.
In collaboration with Heavy Pedal.
Very nice.
So, shout out to Roz,
ding.
Shout out to Heavy Pedal.
Ding, ding, ding.
Yeah. I feel like our team is run like a small government. Like people actually.
By the people, for the people.
By the people, for the people. So it's like cool that I feel like we're like, I don't know. Like if I want something to happen on the team or if Chris wants something to happen to the team, like someone wants something to happen to the team, they just like talk to us and we like do it, you know?
It's
a collective.
My favorite news.
Let's go. Look at this. We got the hall. I don't know which is which. Does it matter?
Both Californias.
Yeah. All right, so I guess this is a really important time to talk about your nutrition plan and diet.
Oh boy.
They're obviously very strict.
Yeah, super, super strict.
Yeah.
My nutrition
plan. That's a hoss.
Oh yeah, this is an absolute hog of a burrito.
All right, your nutrition plan.
My nutrition plan is that I am never hungry. Okay. I eat a lot.
Yeah.
And I eat a lot of sugar, namely candy.
Uh-huh.
And I eat whatever the hell I want.
Shout out Charlie Crawlers.
Yeah, shout out to Skittles and shout out to Haribo.
Is this thing gonna fire like I'm expecting it to?
It always does.
Okay, here we go.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Seal of approval.
Yeah.
Stamped.
California's finest.
It's gonna look cool when I do it in post. I'm gonna put a slam sound.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's it. All right, green sauce or red sauce? What's the move?
Dude.
I'm going with green because I'm loyal to the green at all establishments, but.
If you eat green sauce, you're a sick man. You're a sick man. My recent weight goals though have been, I finally hit 200 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
I've been trying to go up.
So you're on the WWE circuit next year?
Yeah, right. I'm playing linebacker for the Ravens next year. I was like always too big for road racing.
Uh-huh.
So I was like, I'm always gonna get just my ass handed to me by some like 14-year-old kid who weighs 95 pounds.
Yes. Piss and vinegar.
So I was like, dude, why am I trying to be tiny? I should just be big and be strong and race things that suit people who are big and strong. Right now, I'm really obsessed with the 4K.
Okay.
Which is a track race. It's just a 4-kilometer time trial. I want to do a 440 outdoors, which is brisk. I recently did my fastest ever 4K, like a week ago. I did a 450, which is, I'm excited about.
You probably average like 200 watts, right?
Like 190.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so you recently retired.
Yeah, I'm retired.
Tell me about that. From crit racing, right?
From crit racing.
Okay.
I'm retired from crit racing, but I still race crits sometimes.
You had transcended basically the ranks of crits.
Mm-hmm.
You were obviously way stronger than everybody else.
There was nothing left there for me.
Yeah,
you know?
I mean, it's really hard to drive 2 hours, pay a lot of money for the same old stuff.
Race 90 minutes.
Yep. Where it always comes down to a field sprint.
Uh-huh.
And especially in a four-corner office park crit,
mm-hmm.
0.9 miles long.
Yeah.
Yeah. Super entertaining stuff.
I have no
idea why you would retire from that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just 33-mile-an-hour crash fests. You know, now that I'm saying this, I should go back. So I've just, like, completely given up on having long power, or on short power.
Mm.
My sprint is, like, the worst it's ever been. But.
But your mid-range, VO2, stuff like that.
Dude, my mid-range is putting up numbers.
There you go. Your FTP is at least 700.
It probably is, yeah, 650.
Yeah, I'm sitting at like 625. So proportionally, it makes sense weight-wise.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, so when did you start racing track? And why the draw towards that?
Is this just
natural transition for like a fixie kid, you know, BMX fixie kid, just track?
Actually, the first type of bike racing that I ever got like exposed to was track racing.
Okay.
Like in person. There's a velodrome up in Washington called Jerry Baker Velodrome. Shout out to Jerry Baker Velodrome. Shout out to Amara, who runs the track up there. She's awesome. I went out to one of their Friday nights, which is like their big Pro 1-2, you know, all the lights, beer garden, food truck.
And you're like, all these people without brakes going around in circles at 40 miles an hour seems like a fun thing to do.
Yeah, this is sick.
But naturally, that's where you go.
And then when I moved back down here, the San Diego track racing scene is dope too. You can race your bike against kids who like won national titles. You know, every week.
As we've seen. They give us a smoke.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out Antonio Rossi.
Ding! Kid whoops my ass. So it was cool to like have this resource in my backyard of like high level bike racing, you know?
You show up, everybody's immediately friendly.
I think that what it is that there's no Instagram famous track racers, really. Like, there's no influencer track racers.
Bro.
Get the sauce off your face. Like, you can message Ashton Lambie on Instagram and he'll respond, you know?
Everybody go message Ashton Lambie.
Everyone go send Ashton Lambie memes about pumpkin spiced everything.
All right, ready?
Let's bounce.
We'll be right back. What's the sickest trick you can do on a BMX bike?
I can like 360 a five stair.
All right, can you do the same thing on your TT bike?
Yes.
So steep.
It's a lot of dogs.
Good Lord, look at all them dogs.
Look at them dogs.
Look at them dogs. They say that for every hot dog you eat, 36 minutes is taking up your life. All them track dogs.
I'd be dead by now.
5,000 hot dogs.
5,000 hot dogs later. That means that two hot dogs is an hour, right? Which means that essentially like 50 hot dogs is a day.
Which means that major stuff.
Like 1,800 hot dogs is a year off your life.
All right. And so if you've eaten 18,000.
If you've eaten 18,000 hot dogs, you die 10 years younger. Which honestly is probably true.
It's probably fine like, though. Okay, but 18,000 hot dogs. That's a lot.
That's a lot of hot dogs.
Yeah. Oh, freaking any gravel
park. You know, now that I've actually broken the math out and thought about that statistic is probably
sense, right?
True.
Yeah. This is a nice street.
I think that what it is it's actually the amount of hot dogs you eat shortens your life exponentially.
Oh.
So like the first hot dog maybe shortens it like a minute.
So they compound because they just.
Yeah, but your 500th hot dog shortens it by like 10 minutes. Your 1,000th hot dog shortens it by like a day.
Do you think that it's like compounded by age that you eat the hot dogs at? Like when you're a kid, you can recover from glizzy intake at like a way higher.
You can hear glizzy gobbling doesn't catch up to you as much. I think that there's definitely some sort of, exponential function that's, modified by number of glizzies consumed.
You're a math major. Could you write that function?
Yeah, definitely. I need some researching. I need a grant.
Partial differential equation. If anybody wants to help Max write a grant.
A grant proposal for glizzy consumption?
Yeah. And by age, function by age.
Yeah.
Hit us up. Drop it in the comments below if you got the chips.
Yeah.
We got the speedway. Hell yeah. Oh no. Surfboard. That's the theme song of this ride. Surfboard.
Riding on that wood.
You get either
blue every time.
Blue every time? You didn't even listen to Revel Berry, dude.
Nah, dude. It goes enlightenment and blue, and then all the rest of the flavors.
Fair enough. All right, so we have two questions left. Okay. First things first. We're going straight to it. Fastest in SoCal. Go.
Ooh, fastest in SoCal. Yeah. I'm gonna give you a list of people.
Oh my
Not
god.
Not one person.
Keeping it complicated.
Esther Walker.
Doc Walk.
Shout out Doc Walk.
Ding.
Antonio Rossi for the juniors. And no pros, right?
I'd say keep the pros out of it.
Keep the pros out of it.
If you really like want to throw a pro in there.
I'm gonna say Doc Walk, Antonio Rossi. The pro honorable mentions are Robin Carpenter and Eddie Huntsman.
Robin doesn't count anymore. He's abandoned San Diego.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
He's out.
All he had to do to win Tour of Britain or win a stage of Tour of Britain was to leave San Diego. I see how it is.
Dude, Noah Slack is also up there. Noah Slack's a monster right now.
Shout out Noah Slack.
The one fastest.
One to rule them all, dude.
One to rule them all. Dude, usually my brain always goes to like big TT dudes, right? So like Corey Lockwood, he's not pro anymore.
He's on the verge of SoCal. Can you call Baco SoCal?
Baco is SoCal. I'm okay. Gonna say Corey Lockwood then.
All right, there you go.
Corey Lockwood's a monster.
Corey gets it.
Yeah.
If you had to change, or you could change, one thing about the culture of cycling in SoCal, or greater, whatever, what would that be?
No more influencers. Get them out of here. No, like, especially LA. LA is run by, like, I don't know, like, cool guy cycling influencers. Less elitism. You know, less elitism, less taking itself so seriously, no more influencers.
Is your bike faster than that?
Harley Davidsons are stupid. You can't convince me otherwise. The American design philosophy is broken. There is a replacement for displacement. You don't need a 7-liter engine to make a car fast.
Big facts.
just because your Harley leaks oil doesn't mean it's good to have oil in it. Stop letting American car companies do this. The Japanese have it figured out. The Europeans have it figured out. Why is the United States the only place where you can buy a 7-liter engine that still gets gapped by a 2-liter Japanese car? What's going on, America? Thank you.